down towards Norton Summit near Moriarty Gorge, and I just thought I'd commentate this and just show you like how confident these guys are on the side of the DM. As you can see, I think we have Michael Hornbuff on the back riding the Specialized Specialized with discs. It's a nice bike. I realized that in the rain none of them broke discs, which I think is weird. That's like disc would be good, but nonetheless, a lot of their sprinters running discs, a lot of them aren't. You see just like how close they are to each other, ahead, how they bump into each other, how they take corners. It's just quite eye-opening, like the confidence that these guys have in each other, which I think, yeah, maybe amateurs have similar confidence, but I was definitely taken by it. And I think it's definitely one thing you can improve by just riding with more people, just like bumping into each other, like realizing that if you crash into someone, like it's not the end of the world. Obviously, like, we'll get to see something quite insane in a bit. I think I described this on the other video, but you can see like there, none of them really stop. Like they're all good at track standing. Like, obviously, they can't track stand, but like they have a lot of confidence. I'm not sure if I got this on camera, but just have a look at this guy further on the road. Yeah. See it, that guy on the right hand side, he's got both his feet off the trampoline, and he's got both his feet off the bike, and he is sitting just on the left hand side. It's actually insane what he's doing. Unfortunately, you can't really see too well, but he's literally sitting on the pedal. It's just obscene. The confidence he has is just crazy. I'll stop it if you want to see it. But yeah, like Bunny Hop being. Like they do just moves confidence on the bike. This is just really chill. They're all having a joke, having a laugh, like talking to them. It's just like that's insane. And like some of them, I think obviously they're not as confident, but that guy was just really special. But this is the thing, like the training rides when they're going easy, I think they get a bit bored, so they're just chilling out. So on the roundabouts. They take roundabouts pretty fast, they don't really look very much. But even here, like the bus sort of slams on its brakes, like all these guys. Whoa, what's going on? I could see it was happening as it went around. But yeah, like they just very confident, just cruising along, very easy. It's just good to watch them. Pretty high cadence on these riders. They really have a nice pedaling technique, all of them, definitely. You can see someone running two bottles somewhere in one. Wouldn't even team card doesn't matter that much, to be honest. But if you're an amateur, I always recommend bring you a little bit of water, because there's nothing worse than less water. That being slightly dehydrated or just not drinking as much as you need to. So yeah, it's good to just, you know, drink something. That's one thing these guys do. They definitely are very, very well hydrated. Like, I think they must get a lot of water. Quite a hot day on that day. I think it was about 20-30 degrees. But yeah, it's a good ride for these guys. You can see that the Quickstep guys, I don't think we're taking this too seriously. They're not super lean or like that. It just takes a step up. It's just like so easy. Their balance is just really incredible. And like when they go around corners, it's just pretty chill for them. You can see Morkov had a really nice cadence. Dropped to the spooring there and just really like spinning very, very nicely. Some of them, like, they'll just grind it a little bit just to get out of the saddle. And there you can see, like, again, he's at the hands off the handlebars, just like chill, just doing whatever needs to be done. It's pretty good. Like, going around the corners. Again, you can see they pedal around most corners because they're going quite slowly. That's what they remember. Maybe when you don't race, like, the whole time, you sort of forget about pedaling around corners. But these guys, obviously, are such experienced racers that they just know exactly where they can pedal. Start, you'll see generally they pedal a little bit before where most other riders would. They're also just very confident and very good at using the draft. They don't really expend much energy. I think a good thing that I remember reading in Phil Diamond's book is he'd compare his average power, normalized power, to other riders. And what you want if you're sitting in the bunch is like the lowest normalized power. I remember him saying that he knew he was getting good at bike racing, not because of necessarily his results, but just because he can decrease Shimano subsidiary, it's basically their company, on their specialized bikes. Which is really weird because on the bench, like, they got their own, like, proprietary step bars and stuff, so really weird. I don't know what is it. It must have been Viviani came on and was like, don't like these bars, can we use these ones instead? And maybe Gaviria tried them, was like, yeah, I like them as well. And then all the other guys, they're not sprinters, so they probably don't really. As like as effective as much, because obviously they're not putting as much power through the pedals. But you can see, we got up to like 300 watts. I remember doing up here. It was like decently tough, and they're just out of the saddle grinding. You can see like they're pretty. They don't use very much energy when they're out of the saddle. They really just try and like keep their body as still as possible and just move their bike and just save some energy. And you can see different rider physiologies. Every mass is very, very thin legs. It doesn't really. I've said this many multiple times. Really pick up on the camera, but some of the guys, more sprinter type guys, which is the bigger guys, generally have quite large legs. Sprinters definitely do have bigger calves. That's one thing I noticed from this thing. Like Kib Uni has huge calves. Like they're almost wider than they are tall. Like they're just huge, which is must be some cycling phenomenon, because I know often sprinters in running they have really thin, tiny calves because that's the weight that they have to move. Obviously in cycling that's power generator that coughs. So you can see we're just cruising along here. It's just very, very chilled, very calm. That's one thing I'd say in a pro, when you're riding with the pros, is like you never feel like anything's going wrong. You're just chilling out with them. Like they're just very smooth. You don't really need to pay attention because they're just doing it for you. They point out the holes. They point out when there's traffic. Like you know, it's all good. Roundabouts, you just go with them. They're just a bit nuts on roundabouts.
Apparently, someone, the team mechanic, was saying because it was basically because they're from Europe, so they're used to looking left, not right. But I don't even know. There's been some dodgy things where the front guys will just go and then sort of forget that they've got like the whole team plus like 10 whatever random vegans on the back, like hanging on to the group or whatever. So obviously, they like. I mean, you're just not used to it. And when they're in races, obviously it's just full gas, so you don't even have to wait in the roundabouts. It must be weird for them. I guess they do ride a lot outside races, but it must be sometimes something odd because they sort of expect themselves to have right of way because obviously when they race, there's no messing around. There's no waiting for traffic lights or anything. But you can see like they like to use the scoring a bit more than I thought they would. Like I always thought that they. Often in races it makes sense to use the bigger. I think in training they really try and just use the small ring to spin the legs as much as possible. Especially because they've just flown here, so they just want to like chill the legs out, not go too hard or anything. Which is obviously good for them. So you can see that guy who's got pushed on the side or comes back, then he'll like roll on, bump into another guy, and like it's all just a lot of bunch confidence, which is good to see, and it's nice to like, I don't know, just learn from them, see what they do, and see how you can improve your confidence. And I think one thing is just go to a grassy area with a mate, just bang into each other as much as possible, do loads of different like simulation of just like not crashing, but sort of having a bit of shoulder barge. So just realize that if you hit someone in a bike race, it's not the end of the world. It's just so we're just turning out to Norton Summit Road on the left, like they will in the race. I won't be doing the race. And so yeah, cheers for watching, and I'll see you in the next bit.